From microscopic organisms to things we would never recognize. Stay tuned to number one to find out 10 types of life forms that may exist in our universe. Number 10, humanoid life. To be clear, I'm not talking about other human beings out there in the universe, though technically speaking, yes, that is still possible. Rather, I'm talking about other forms of humanoid life that could exist out there in some form. The word humanoid is a reference to how humans can talk, walk on two legs, stand upright, and stuff like that. And if you think about every single legendary sci-fi show that's ever existed that featured other life forms, then you'll remember that there were other humanoid life forms out there. Klingons, Romulans, Vulcans, Narns, Centauri, Vorlons, and more. And each of them were a race that were humanoid and not yet quite human. Given the vast expanse of the universe and the fact that we know that there are planets out there like Earth where the conditions are right to breed life, it goes to reason that there could indeed be another humanoid species out there. And depending on distance and their state of evolution, it could explain why we haven't been able to find them, contact them, or even locate a trace of them. We're but one small speck in a massive universe, and if they're at the same stage of technology as we are, then they may not have found Earth, just like we have not found their planet. Yet. Number 9. Aquatic life. Sticking with what is very likely or possible, we are pretty positive that there are other planets out there in the universe that have water, and in fact, we have found several planets very recently that we have confirmed this fact to the best of our current ability. The waters of Earth are full of life, both known and even unknown, which is why many dedicate their lives to finding the life within the oceans that hasn't been discovered yet. Given that we know there is water out there, and given we know that life can live in waters of various kinds, such as salt water, fresh water, and even acidic in some cases, it's very logical and believable to say that there could be aquatic life out there in the oceans of various planets. Now, if you were to ask me, well, what do they look like? I honestly couldn't even fathom a guess. It's not because I lack an imagination, but rather, the life within our own oceans is as varied, if not more varied, than the life on the land. So trying to predict the way that creatures of another world would evolve would be nearly impossible. And if you don't believe me on that front, you should check out our videos on what lies in the deepest parts of our own oceans, specifically in the Mariana Trench, and then you'll see just how weird our planet's evolution can get. Number 8. Silica-based life. Before we talk about this potential life form, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by using the buttons below. Silica is something that is used in more places than you'd think, and that's because the molecules of silicon are actually very similar to carbon, which you'll see later in this list. And so we use it in things like concrete, computer chips, prosthetics, body enhancements, and more. So, by that token, if something as versatile as silica can be used for various objects in the inanimate sense, it goes to reason that, in the right circumstances, they could be used to make life. This isn't just speculation, though. There are creatures on our own Earth today that have used silica as building blocks of their own body's construction, such as algae called diatoms. It's primitive in how it's used, but weren't we all primitive at one time? And if it works in some form here, maybe it works in greater forms out there. Number 7. Panspermia life. Now, this isn't the name of a fantasy world. It's actually a scientific theory for how life could be born on other planets. Not by natural growth, or at least not at first, but rather, items like comets, meteors, asteroids, and other such carriers bring life to other planets. This would mean that life could actually survive on said places, which is hard to believe, but not impossible. Well, not technically. As we have things on Earth that could indeed survive the harsh climates of outer space. This is certainly a new twist on, is there life out there? Because it would be possible to have life on various rocks scattered throughout the known universe. The question only is, which ones? Number 6. No life. The antithesis of are we alone in the universe question is as simple an answer as anything else. Yes. Scientifically speaking, it's nearly impossible to think that there's no life out there in the world if everything is random and fair. But as our own Earth has shown us, sometimes the odds aren't random or fair. If the universe was made by the Big Bang, then a series of circumstances had to happen in order for the Earth to not only grow to be habitable, and trust me, there were a lot of extinction-level events before humans came around, but also for life to grow. Other planets may not have gotten that chance at all, or even the hope of a chance. Or if you believe in God, or any religion, then you'll note that the sacred texts don't state that life is out there, because the gods only made one homeworld. So while science does state that there is a high probability of life being out there, that same probability also states that there might be none at all. Number 5. Arsenic-based life. This one might seem a bit odd to you, as arsenic on Earth is incredibly poisonous. So how is it that it could be used to make a form of life on another planet? This is because arsenic has many similarities structurally to phosphorus, which, if you didn't know, is one of the staples of life on Earth. To that end, if reworked in certain ways on other planets, it could easily be one of the building blocks of other life forms. It's said that early stages of life from our own planet could have used arsenic as a building block in very specific places, like geothermal vents. So, if we could do it here, it could happen anywhere. Number 4. Hybrid life. You may think that I'm referencing how in certain fantasy cultures there are things like centaurs and minotaurs that are mixes of human and animals. And that's technically plausible, but in this case, I refer to hybrid nature in regards to being primarily made of two different substances instead of just one. Our world is made of carbon-based life forms, in many ways, but not all planets have that, and thus they would have to be comprised of other things. Yet that doesn't restrict them to being made of just one thing. Because, potentially, they could take bits and pieces of other chemicals, substances, and materials from their worlds and comprise different parts of their bodies, including ones that don't have carbon at all. Trying to discern how these creatures would look or live is impossible. But as in all things, there's a beauty in regards to how things adapt and survive, even in the harshest of situations. And as Jeff Goldblum once said, life finds a way. Number 3. Carbon-based life. Humans are comprised of many carbon atoms. Did you know that? In fact, most life on Earth has a form of carbon within them. So if we're talking about scientifically possible life out there in the stars, there's no doubt that we have to conclude that other planets have the potential for carbon-based life forms as well. If for no other reason then, this is what we know right here on Earth. And if it can happen on Earth, why can't it happen elsewhere? Now, a common misconception is that carbon-based life forms on other planets would look like creatures from our worlds. This isn't necessarily the case, for the simple reason that every world is different. And so far, though we have found Earth-like planets, we haven't found a perfect match. Which means that if carbon-based life is out there, it would have to go through its own evolutionary cycle in order to grow. Which further means that they may look vastly different than the creatures of our own world. Oddly enough, that sounds kind of appealing, don't you think? Number 2. God life. This is the question, isn't it? Is there a god, or gods, who helped create everything? Now you might be wondering why I'm including this on a list about scientifically possible life, but that's the thing. There are scientists out there who believe that they have evidence of a god, or gods. Mainly because there are things that happen on this Earth that can't be explained, not even with modern science. One of the biggest and most prevalent theories is that about how the Earth was allowed to have life at all. Think about it. The Earth is perfectly placed in our solar system. We have a sun that gives us just enough warmth to survive, and just enough light that we don't roast all day. If we were closer to the sun, we'd burn, like Venus or Mercury. If we were farther away though, we'd freeze, like Mars. How is it that a celestial event like the Big Bang could have put the Earth so perfectly in place? Doesn't seem logical, does it? Fast forward to the modern day and you'll hear tales of actual miracles, ones that no scientist can perfectly explain. And they haven't just happened in the modern day, but in the past as well. So when you put all of these facts together, what do you get? For some, you get proof of a god. For others, you get proof that we don't know everything about how the world works. The truth? that's for you to decide. But as science often states, you should always keep an open mind. Number 1. Microscopic life. Let me ask you a question. How tall are you? Are you above average height for your age? Below average height? Right on the line. Come on now, there's no wrong answers here, and I promise that this has a point. The point is simple. You can see life for the most part in our world because it's so big. But every once in a while, there are creatures that are so small that they are dubbed microscopic. They are impossible for the eye to see, or very hard to see on your own. Mites, lice, tardigrades, and others are so incredibly small that you have to be looking right at them in order to ensure they're seen. And that's the point I'm trying to make here. If you believe in the theory of evolution, we all started on the Earth as similar microscopic organisms. And then slowly, over the millennia, we grew more advanced. There's a big question in the world today of, are we alone? And if we aren't, why haven't we seen any other forms of life yet? Well, it might just be that because of the very nature of life itself and all of the struggles that it has to go through in order to make things work and keep working, that other planets out there haven't gotten the fast track that we on Earth have been on. And while satellites have taken pictures of other planets, there is no way that those cameras are powerful enough to see any life, let alone microscopic organisms. So it may be possible that there is life on other planets at this very moment. It's just, we can't see it right now. Do you believe in life on other planets? Let us know in the comments below, and take care.